Thanks, Gary. The USDA's move to Kansas City could be in question after some legal issues came up earlier this week. New here at 5, with the clock ticking down, KCTV5's Caroline Sweeney went to find out what this could mean for downtown KC.
The USDA is in trouble because they didn't check their budget before they announced the move to KC. A federal watchdog group called out the department for not following the proper steps before the move was finalized. It's kind of like this. You go out and buy a fancy, flashy new sports car, but you didn't check with your partner to see if the money was there. And you didn't explain why you needed this sports car when the minivan you have is working great. Now the move to KC could be in jeopardy, even though it looked pretty good from the start.
We've got a different growing world, a different consumer base out there for food products today, and it's very important that we modernize USDA.
That was the United States Agriculture Secretary Sonny Perdue back in June.
But the USDA just tried to move, or did move, two offices out of Washington, D.C., I think to Kansas City, Missouri. Yes, you can applaud that one, because that's what we've been talking about doing. Guess what happened?
The workers refused to leave D.C. In this speech, Acting White House Chief of Staff Mick Mulvaney joked it was a good way to streamline government.
USDA is supposed to be the people's department. It's supposed to work for the people. And they're just treating their workforce really badly here and making them suffer.
Two-thirds of the employees don't want to move to the metro. If they don't, they lose their jobs. And now the department may not have the money to make the move. Plus, Congress thinks the agency can't move without permission. Lawmakers are saying it's time to gas up that minivan and return the sports car. We reached out to several groups to find out what this means for KC. We're still working to get the answers, but we do know there are USDA employees already here working at a temporary office. Caroline Sweeney, KCTV5 News.